going to add in 1 liter of milk. So I'm using this cold pressed raw milk. I did find organic milk. They weren't really local. A lot of them were from Victoria or Queensland. I thought, being in New South Wales, you may as well use something from New South Wales. Next step is to add our sachet of cultures. This is freeze-dried cultures, made in the UK from imported ingredients, which I'm not too overly excited about. So this is about 45 hours after the initial milk fear grains went in. I left them overnight with the rubber band and cheesecloth on top.
It smells a lot like cheese. Not sour as such. Not too sure if this is supposed to happen.
You can see there is a super thick layer on top. It's almost like a creamy cheese.
Ew.
I've strained out my grains from the milk, and as you can see, there's a lot of grains. Now I'm going to give it a try.
You're nasty.
There's no place for rather be.
My homemade milk kefir with products in the market, I went out to see what was already available. I wanted to understand the standard of commercial milk kefir and also understand what consumers like and what they expected. The first brand I discovered was called Blue Bay. They offered a cow's milk kefir and also a goat's milk kefir. On this product, I was also very impressed with their ingredients. There was only 3 ingredients and they were just very relevant and just made sense. The second brand in this store was named Babushka. This product I was quite shocked with. Their milk kefir products had lengthy, irrelevant ingredients such as sweeteners and proteins. This is when I knew that I wanted my homemade milk kefir to be as simple as possible. After visiting Sharon up at the fermentary in Castle Maine, I felt inspired to give my second attempt a go. Sharon also gave me a little bit of advice on what local milks to use. That is when I decided to go and purchase some St. David's dairy milk. After researching the history and culture of milk kefir, I knew the process of kefir making was meant to be simple and done with wholesome, accessible ingredients. Alrighty, so we've got our reduced fat milk, as advised by Sharon. This is St. David's dairy. Today I'm attempting my second trial of milk kefir. I'm using local reduced fat milk produced at the micro dairy in my area. As it is advised that using reduced fat milk will produce a thinner milk kefir, I thought this was very appropriate as my milk kefir was very, very thick last time. I think this will be a bit of an improvement. So this is 23 hours after I first put the grains in. As you can see, there is no thick layer on top like last time. It's very thin. It looks just like milk, really. Nothing's really happened visually. It does smell... It smells very cheesy still, so I'm a little bit worried, but we'll see how it goes once I've strained out the grains. I'm going to be straining out the grains this time around a little bit differently as I don't have a proper colander with me. I'm going to be using the cheesecloth. I'm basically just going to pull out any grains that I can see. From what I can see, my milk kefir has no grains at all. I'm literally not straining anything out, which is a bit concerning. In the process of things, I've also managed to make a huge mess, but hey, priorities. Got our labelled product. Well, it tastes very different. Although I think that's actually okay, maybe. It tastes a bit cheesy, but it's not fizzy. It is quite sour though. So I've either made a sour off milk, or maybe this is worse.